the South China Sea's issues. Do you think the game is now there? Has it had anything to do with the Vietnamese anymore?
I think the first thing about the South China Sea is that it dispels the myth that China has this great strategic vision that's seen way into the future. I mean, if they do have that vision, it's how do we make the whole world mad at us and distrust us? I mean, what they're doing to these territories of Vietnam and the Philippines and others is just outrageous. Going in there, they're destroying coral reefs, and they're claiming territory that clearly isn't theirs. They have no legal justification. So if I were advising the government of China, I'd say, well, if you want to give everybody in Asia a good reason to be close to the Americans, just keep on doing what you're doing.
But the Chinese government keeps saying they have the historical right to the area.
They don't. As simple as that. They will never control those sea lanes. Japan will never permit it. And the United States will never permit that. It won't come to that.
But would it come to a war?
If China wouldn't back off, yes, it's the kind of situation that it really is dangerous. I'm not the expert on the South China Sea that BBC's Bill Hayton and others are, but I started writing about this back in the 1990s, and then it was hard to see that China would continue its course of action, and I just think they're being foolish, and sooner or later they'll have to back off and be responsible.
Has the mood in the U.S. has changed toward China over the South China Sea?
I just think the mood is that we don't trust those guys anymore, and we have to deal with them, but watch them.